So what's your what's the issue now? Is it a First Amendment issue, Ben, or is it an issue of that you think the school officials overreacted?
Hoppy, it's really both at this point. I mean, ultimately, it's boiling down to a First Amendment issue. And as I heard your commentary a moment ago, that he wore a shirt to school that had a NRA logo and a hunting rifle and the phrase "Protect Your Right," which is protected political speech. And he wore that shirt because he thought it was a cool shirt. He saw it at Cabela's over the weekend. He purchased it, and Thursday was the first opportunity that he wore it. And he went through homeroom, first, second, third, fourth, and fifth period, and nobody said anything. The shirt had not caused any disruption to the educational process, nor had Jared. And when he was at the lunch line, this particular teacher thought or believed it violated the dress policy, which clearly it does not. I've met with the Logan County Board of Education's attorney and superintendent briefly yesterday, and they both assured me that it was not. And Jared did wear the same shirt back to school, along with 100 other students that wore the same identical shirt throughout the county and most of the schools. But what had happened was, when the teacher believed that it was improper, he seemed to have overreacted based on the eyewitness accounts that I have. You know, in today's mobile society, there's a lot of smartphones out there and a lot of video, and in addition to video in the school. So we've been able to secure some of that. We've been able to take statements from some of the students. And what I'm seeing and the evidence that I have at this point is the teacher immediately got very close to Jared in his space. Told him to turn the shirt inside out, take it off, or go to the office, for he'd be expelled or further disciplined. And Jared started engaged into a bait of, why do I have to take it off? There's nothing wrong with it. I don't think it's against the policy. I have a right. Jared is an honor roll student. According to the principal yesterday, he's not been in trouble at the school. I think there was one minor incident. He was called to the office. She didn't go into it because he was a juvenile. But for the most part, he's a good student. Made the honor roll. Wants to go into the military. Wants a career in the military, just like his stepfather. And he felt like his rights were violated, and he tried to engage in a debate. And my issue right now is that I really believe that they're teachers. They're educated. They've went to school. They've handled students for years. And I would think that one could have the ability, or should have the ability, to engage in a debate with a student without it escalating to the point to where the police are summoned.
And Ben, I'll get to that in a second concerning the police. But isn't there also a point where, because schools have additional opportunities, but rights to regulate because of, you know, what are called legitimate educational reasons. So if a teacher makes a request of a student or tells a student, take that shirt off or turn that shirt inside out, isn't it in the best interest of everybody to do that and to obey what the teacher tells you, unless it's unreasonable, and then sort it out later rather than getting into an argument with the teacher?
Hoppy, I mean, perhaps. I'm not going to agree to that fully. I mean, I think the adult needs to be the adult, whether it's a teacher or a psychiatrist or anything. I mean, the adult needs to be the adult, and the adult should have taken those steps. I mean, I don't think we want to put that burden on a 14-year-old child to be the bigger person. And I don't think that if anybody, you, me, a 14-year-old child, if we're commanded to do something wrong, even in the military, when I was in the military, I was in the infantry, and we had to take orders and follow orders, but we were still instructed that if an officer gives us an illegal command or something we know is wrong, we don't have to do it. And I don't think that stops with a 14-year-old. I think they should be able, and Jared's pretty mature. And so, no, ultimately, I don't think that a child, when giving an illegal command to do something that's not right, should follow through with it. I mean, where do you draw that line?
Ben White is the attorney for Jared Marcum, the 15-year-old who wore the NRA logo T-shirt, Protect Your Right. It caused a dust-up at Logan Middle School. He eventually ended up at the office. Eventually, the police were called. Was there something that happened, and everybody saw what happened in the cafeteria, and the kids started chanting at one point, so it got a little bit rambunctious. Was there a point, though, and I know he's your client, but was there a point when Jared got to the office when things got heated to the point where the police, in fact, did need to be called?
Well, my understanding, the police were called before he got to the office. The principal, when she looked outside the glass windows and saw the students rising, and from what I'm being told by the school officials, some of them did step up on the table and was chanting Jared's name or "Go Jared" as he was being walked to the office. And that's when that decision was made. And I wasn't there. I haven't seen the video. But my understanding is, I will concur on this point, is from talking to the officer, one of the officers that was there, Jared would not be quiet. He kept saying, "This is wrong. I didn't do anything wrong. If you're going to arrest me, arrest me." And yes, I would have preferred Jared to stop at that point, but he didn't. He engaged into a banter with the police officer of, "I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't do anything wrong." But again, I think from the pressures and the embarrassment that he was subjected to, you know, I'm not Jared. I wasn't there, so I don't know. It's sort of he said, she said, your word against ours. Unfortunately, the video doesn't have audio, so I can't tell what Jared would have said when I do get to see the video. But according to the adults that were there, he did not stop debating about the issue. The police officer, Mr. Atkins, asked him to be quiet. I've heard people say shut up, and I don't think shut up was used, but Jared did refuse to stop talking, and the officer at that point, based on the facts I've seen, had no other choice than to detain him. And he did in a very professional way. The Logan City Police, as far as Officer Atkins, I think did a great job in handling and defusing the situation and removing Jared from what was continuing to escalate.
Ben, we have an interesting situation here because, we have followed this for a couple of days now, is you may have a teacher overreacting to what was a piece of clothing that was not in violation of the dress code and probably protected by the First Amendment. That again gets a little bit hazy, which we can get into. But then that triggers a reaction by him that then warrants the police to do something. So you've really got almost two issues here, and one is linked to the other. And you know, Ben, you've been around a while. If you say to a police officer, "If you want to arrest me, go arrest me." And I guess what? They're going to get arrested. You know, I mean, that's.
So it is a bifurcated issue. There are two issues. And my position at this point is sort of the but-for issue. But for the teacher's overreaction, these things wouldn't have happened. So we're pursuing down both avenues right now. Charges have not been filed, and I want to make that clear. I met with the prosecutor's office yesterday, and I have a lot of respect for our prosecutor, Mr. Bennett. He's done a great job since he's been elected as prosecutor, and the juvenile prosecutor is Sabrina Deskins, and I met with her, and I know her. She's very thorough, and she will be very fair in her investigations before she decides if charges are warranted or not. And at this point, from the evidence that I've seen, I don't think that charges should be warranted, other than when he didn't stop talking. I think that's sort of an area that David had to do what he did, Mr. Atkins, and we'll see how that plays out. But we will defend Jared vehemently if charges are filed. But the bigger issue, like we've talked about, is the overreaction to the T-shirt. I mean, that same day, there was a child in the school that I did see in one of the cell phone videos that had a Mountaineer shirt on with the WVU Mountaineer. And, you know, I was the Mountaineer several years ago.
Yes, you were.
And I can't see a difference. I mean, if the teacher's belief was that because it had this rifle on it, it's against the policy, which clearly it's not. And why would he have allowed the student, if he saw him, that had the WVU Mountaineer with the musket? And I'm not saying that should be banned, because I'm a firm believer in the Second Amendment. I own firearms. I'm an NRA member. I was the Mountaineer, and I've got a huge statue of the Mountaineer and a musket in his hand right here in my office. But it's hard to draw that line. I mean, then you've got to distinguish, well, what about the jet plane that's on the kid's Air Force shirt with the bombs on it? What about the statue out in the parking lot that is immoral to their veterans? How can you draw a line, Hoppy?
Well, I don't know. I don't know exactly where you draw the line, except that, as we've talked about many times in this discussion, and other discussions similar to this, Ben, is we know that you still have constitutional rights. I mean, students have constitutional rights inside the school yet, and you know, because you referred the cases to me yesterday, is that schools also have a right, though, to regulate and control the environment for legitimate educational purposes. So it's not like the students have these unfettered rights that can't be infringed upon because there is an educational mission that also factors into this. So it's a...
There is, and I'd be happy to touch on that briefly.
Sure,
if
go ahead.
Allow me, but if not, that's okay.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
Well, I mean, the standard, the courts have spoken clearly that it has to be a material disruption that involves substantial disorder. And what Jared was doing by wearing the shirt doesn't rise to any of those levels. I mean, it was a static display on a shirt. He wasn't doing anything. And that's where I get to my but for. But mm-hmm. for this teacher's improper reaction. I mean, what the teacher, in my opinion, should have done was when he looked at that shirt and he thought that it was against the dress code, he should have acted like an adult or an educator and reviewed the policy briefly. It's online. I'm sure it's throughout the school in the handbooks. Or went to the principal and said, I think this shirt may not fall into our policy, but I want you to tell me what to do. Get some guidance, because the teacher doesn't have the authority to suspend the child, and he mentioned suspension to him. And we look at the Tinker case, which I think was a 1968 case.
Right.
Students wore black armbands in protest of the Vietnam War. And in that case, the students were arguing amongst themselves in the hallways, but the court ended up ruling that even though they were arguing, it caused some uncomfortableness, it didn't disrupt their, it didn't take their minds off of their classroom work, and that the classroom is a marketplace of ideas, and we should be able to have discussions about things like this. But more important, or not more importantly, but back to the beginning, it was an overreaction by some educator that believed that it was against the school policy, and I think just went down the wrong road. And he may have very well, Poppy, been acting outside of the scope of his employment when he did this, because he didn't have the authority, from my understanding, with the school board attorney yesterday to make the call of suspending the student.
So what's the way out? How do we resolve this? What's the way out here so we can all get back to normal?
Well, what Jared's family wants at this point is they want the suspension removed. We don't know what's going to happen with the criminal charges. We'll take that day by day as the prosecutor gathers more evidence, and we are fully cooperating with them to supply any evidence that we have come upon, whether it be cell phone video or audio, to give them as well to help them in making that decision, good or bad. And so the criminal charges per se, we just have to deal with those as they come. But as far as the school is, we would like for the school board to take a position on, do they support the teacher's actions? If yes, then we deal with that. If no, then we file an action against the teacher himself for a violation of Jared's First Amendment rights is where it's going to go to for us, because the courts also have said that a violation of those rights doesn't have to be for a certain amount of time. Loss of First Amendment freedoms, even for a minimal period of time, unquestionably constitutes irreparable injury. And that's one of the elements we would have to prove in a First Amendment case. And I think we have that with him being instructed to turn the shirt inside out, take it off, or be suspended.
Ben White.
So I think what's going to happen, depending on how the school board reacts as far as are they supporting their teacher or did he act outside the scope, a suit. Looks like it will be filed for a violation of a First Amendment action through the teacher, possibly the school board as well. But my impression yesterday in meeting with the attorney and the superintendent, they want to do what's right. I know those folks very well. They seem or have given me the appearance that they want to do the right thing. They're drawing a line on the suspension because their position is the suspension came from the disruption of the school process,
right,
educational process. But my position there is it wasn't substantial. It didn't meet the burden that's called for in the case law that's preceded it.